Welcome back to my YouTube channel, that is Maths with Shivangi Nagar. In this video we will discuss the second question of the exercise 4.1 exercise, right? So what we have to do in this question, we have to represent the following situation in the form of the quadratic equation. Here we have total three subparts, and all the subparts we are given the word problems, okay, and we have to convert them mathematically and we have to form the quadratic equation. What the first question says, the area of a rectangular plot is 528 meters square. So in the first line we are given the area of the rectangular plot, that is 528 meters square. Then we are given a comparative information between the length and the breadth of the same rectangular plot. What is given? The length of the plot is one more than the twice its breadth. So if we take the, let's say the breadth be x, so according to this information what we are given, that the length of the plot is what? 2x plus 1 meter. Now we will use this area of the rectangular plot, okay. So what is the area of the rectangular plot? Area of the rectangular plot is length into breadth, right? So what is the length here in the terms of x? Here it is what? 2x plus 1. And what is the breadth? Breadth is what? X here. So 2x plus 1 into x is what? 528. When you multiply, open the bracket, and when you multiply them, what you will get? 2x square plus x is equals to 528. And when you transpose this 528 on the left hand side, what you will get? 2x square plus x minus 528, which is equals to 0. So this is the required mathematical algebraic representation of this given piece of information. And if you see here, this is what? A quadratic equation, because the highest power of the variable is what? 2. And here we have the equal
now
to sign.
Coming on the next part, what we are given, the product of the two consecutive positive integer is 306. Here we are given the information about consecutive positive integers. So consecutive means what? One after the other. If we talk about 2, 3, 4, they are what? They are the consecutive integers, one after the other. 2 is consecutive to 3. 2 and 4 are consecutive to 3 number. Similarly, 3 and 5 are the consecutive numbers of 4, right? So these are the consecutive numbers. So here we are talking about the consecutive positive integers, okay? So let's say, and they are hidden, we have to find out. So whatever we have to find out, we have to take them as a variable. So whatever I am doing, so two integers we have to take here, because we are talking about the two integers. So let's say the smallest integer be x. So the next integer is what? Then just next higher consecutive integer of the x, so that is what? X plus 1. Then we are given that the product of these two integers is 306. So if we write this sentence, this information in the equation form, how we are going to write? That x into x plus 1 makes what? 306, right? When you multiply, when you open this bracket and multiply this x with x plus 1, what you will be getting here? X square plus x minus 306 is equals to what? 0. So this is the required equation of this given information of this question, okay. Coming on the next part, that is the third subpart. This is a question which is based on the ages, right? What we are given here, the Rohan's mother is 26 years older than him. So if you see this first line is what? It is giving the comparative information between the ages of the what? The ages of Rohan and his mother. And which age? Present age. Okay, because see here, if you see here, the information is what? It is talking about the present age. So if we let the present age of the Rohan be x years. So we are, what we are given, that mama is 26 years older. So how much Rohan's mama's age? So Rohan mother's age is what? X plus 26 years. Then after the second line, we are given that the product of their ages in 3 years, in the years, that is 3 years from now, will be means now we are talking about the future age, okay. And future age after how many years? After 3 years. What we are given, the product of their ages after 3 years will be 360. So if the present ages are these, so after the 3 years, what would be the Rohan stage? So obviously in the present age, if you add the 3, then only you will get the age of the Rohan after the 3 years. So it is what? It is the x plus 3. Similarly, if the present age of the mother is this x plus 26, so what is the age of the mother after 3 years? So it is present age plus 3. That means what? X plus 20, x plus 3, that is x plus 29 years, right? And after 3 years, we are given that product of Rohan age and mother age, they together form what? 360. So what is the Rohan age after 3 years? So it is x plus 3. What is the mother's age after 3 years? It is x plus 29, which is making equal to 360. So when you open these brackets and multiplying them, what you will get? X into x, x square. X into 29, 29x. 3 into x plus 3x. And 3 into 29 is what? 3 into 29, 3, 9 times 27, carry over 2, 3 to the 6, 7, 8, which is equal to what? 360 here. Then what we have? X square plus 29 plus 3. 29 plus 3 is what? 32x. Then transpose this 360 on the left hand side. So it will what? It will be coming as a negative quantity. So 360 and 87, when you solve them, so ultimately 87 is positive and 360 is coming as a negative. So you have to subtract, but and you have to place the sign minus over here. So 10 minus 7 is what? 3. This is 15 and this is 2. 15 minus 8 is 7 and this is 3. This is 2. So minus 273, which makes equals to 0. So this is your required equation of this third part. Okay, coming on the next part. Fourth part is based on the speed distance time based problem. What the question says: a train travels a distance of 480 km at a uniform speed. We are given that let's say this is a train right now at station B and it want to go at the station B, and the distance between them is what? 480 km. Initially the train is moving, let's say, with a speed x km per hour, and it reaches, it completes this entire distance, let's say, in the t1 hour. But due to some, let's say, fault or due to some technical issue, if the speed of the same train we are given here, that it is reduces to 8 km per hour. If the speed had been 8 km per hour less, so if the initial speed is x km, so what after reducing it to 8 km hour, what will be the speed? X minus 8 km per hour. So in that case, what we are given, then it would have taken 3 hours more. Obviously, if the speed is reduces, if distance is constant, then obviously the time taken to cover the same journey is more. So let's say that time is what? T2 here. So we are given the difference between both the situations time. When we have x kilometer per hour, at that time we have T1 time, and when the speed reduces by 8 kilometer, then in that case we are taking the T2 time. And that difference is what? That difference is this 3 hours. Because here what we are written? 3 hours more. So that means here this is given what? This is not the given the time. This is the given the time difference. Okay. So we can say that what? T2 minus T1 is what? 3 hours. And this relation we will use, and we will frame the equation on the basis of this. So the total distance covered is 480 km. Let the speed of the train initially it's x km per hour. So time taken to cover the 480 distance is T1 hours. And if the speed reduces by 8 km per hour, then the speed is what? X minus 8 km per hour. And in that case, the time we will let it as a T2 hours. And we know that the time is what? Time is nothing but the distance upon speed. And we are given that T2 minus T1 is what? 3 here. What is T2? The time taken by the train when the speed reduces by 8 km. Okay, and what is the T1 time? T1 time is what? The time taken by the train when the it is moving with the normal speed. Now, what is t2 here? So, see here, t2 is what? So, time is distance upon speed. So, how much distance we are covering? 480. And with what speed? X minus 8 here. So, the same thing we have put here in place of t2. Similarly, what is the time? t1. t1 is the time taken by the train with the x kilometer per hour and on covering 480 kilometer distance. So, 480 upon x. And this is equal to 3. Then, what I have done? I have taken the LCM here. So, LCM of x minus 8 and x is what? X into x minus 80 here. Clear? Then, after taking LCM, we are opening this bracket on the left hand side numerator part. So, when you are opening this bracket, 480 into x is what? Minus 480x, and minus 480 into minus 8 is what? Plus 3840. Similarly, in the denominator part, when you multiply this x with both the quantity, what you will get? X square minus 80x, right? And then I will transpose this on the right hand side. So, it will get multiplied with the 3 here. So, 3 into x square minus 80. If you see here, this is plus 480x, this is minus 480x. Can we cancel them? Yes. So, on the left hand side, we are just only left over with 3840. Or on the right hand side, when we open this bracket, okay, so 3 get multiplied with both the quantities. So, it will make what? 3x square minus 240x. Then, transpose this 3840 on the right hand side. So, what we will get? 3x square minus 240x minus 3840 is equals to 0. So, this is the required quadratic equation of this given question. So, this is what all about in my this video. After this, we will discuss the next subtopic. We will understand what do we understand by the roots or the solution of the quadratic equation, and how to solve quadratic equation, right? These two topics in the next video we will going to cover. So, if you like my video, give me a thumbs up, do share with your friends, and please stay tuned with the channel. If you're new to my channel, then please to subscribe it and press the bell icon so that you will never miss any of my updates. Till then, bye bye, take care, see you in my next video with the next topic, that is roots and solutions of the quadratic equation.